I've been working on this board now, which is going to form the basis of the workshop stuff I'm hoping to put out for you to help. Maybe about the best part of a week, heat on and off, and I think I'm maybe about halfway there. I think, you know, it's quite surprising how it hasn't progressed. No, each one's progressed at the same speed. Some have hardly started like that one, I think, as pretty well as it was at the beginning of the process. Whereas something, you know, that one is pretty well on its way to being faster. The bits I just can't quite get right, which is why I've added a bit more collage. This one here I thought was finished, but I think when I look at it today, I'll probably do another little bit. And I think that's possibly the danger, that every time I put it on the easel, I want to change something. Sometimes you've just got to say, no, this one has come along. Was originally going to be for a little drawing and painting, did a crivvy, but it wasn't working. I've changed it now, and it's going to be Slane's Castle, the cliffs at Slane's Castle, from another study I did. Most of the work here, I mean, I'm not just, it's all just come out of my head. These are basically paintings I've maybe worked on before on a bigger scale, and I'm now trying to do them into this idea. So I do have an idea of where I'm going, but not a great idea. That's going to be a couple of beached boats on the Isle of Harris. They've used the Isle of Harris gin as part of the collage, and I don't think that's very far away, in that, although it doesn't look nearly finished, I don't think there's an awful lot more to be done to that one. That one is, I hope, there's going to be a still life. That's pretty sure. I've started to put in the table, but not there. That was Windy Edge. That was a scene I drew very, very early on in my career when I lived in Newton Hill. One I'm very familiar with, and I thought I wanted to have things that I was used to working with. So it's very nearly there, not too bad, but needs a little bit of fine tuning. That was again, I thought was nearly finished. I'm wondering about how to finish it off, as it just looks a little bit incomplete. That one I'll hope to spend some time on today. Again, it's a typical Bogue scene with the dark trees, houses, and the bright foreground. This one is a painting of the Coolans, Red Coolans in Skye, and I've been actually doing a lot of paintings of Skye recently, and again I think that's pretty nearly there, though it won't take long to finish it, but it'll be quite important what happens. That one I'm just not sure, hasn't moved on at all. What's holding me back with that one and that one is that I like the bits that are there so much I don't want to cover them up. Well, I have to try and work out what the subject matter I can integrate that into without covering over. This one's definitely going to be a little still life painting. You can see the table there. I mean, I'm using these little drawings to work from, little sketches, compositional sketches, just to give me an idea. There's another set of them. This, believe it or not, is the sort of grid system which I've, with my code numbers, which will give me a clue as to where I get totally lost to be able to refer to these paintings, so I'm get the know where I'm going. So I'm having fun. It's a bit exasperating sometimes in that the canvas I've used, which is a canvas I've had for, that canvas is at least 40 years old. I got that when I was from an old jute mill in Dundee when I was a teacher at St John's, and I just lost it and I found it again, a big roll of it. So, and it's got a lovely weave, quite a textural, but it's maybe just a bit too textural for the scale I'm working on, so it's not helping me all that much, but I'm sure I'll get through that. So that's where I am just now. I hope to get these all out, in the not too distant future, as a sort of package of learning materials, and I hope that you get what I'm trying to do, and that it will help you to get what you're trying to get. Thank you.